Hej, cześć i czołem, z tej strony zupełnie absolutny. Zapraszam na 47 odcinek z Mafią 3. Właściwie już wszystkich załatwiliśmy i musimy się tylko porozmawiać z Donovanem i ojcem Jamesem. Zostawiłem to na jakby oddzielny odcinek, ale też chciałem się tutaj zainteresować tym miejscem, bo wcześniej nie było ono dostępne. I zobaczyć, czy w ogóle coś tu jest ciekawego. Tak z ciekawości. Obawiam się, to wszystko jest zablokowane i tutaj nic nie zdziałam. Tak myślałem, zobaczcie tutaj. Droga zamknięta. I sobie tam nie pojadę. Szkoda. No dobra. To w takim razie pora wracać. To jest jedyna droga. Się przyjrzeć jedynie, co tam jest. Jakaś ulica. Ale nic szczególnego tam nie ma. Okej. No to jedziemy. W poprzednim odcinku niestety też gra mi się zacięła i to w takim bardzo kluczowym momencie podczas nagrywania rozmowy finałowej. Dlatego tam na pewno zauważyliście krótki brak dialogu. A nie było to jakieś, wydaje mi się, bardzo kluczowe. Niestety nie wiem dlaczego, ale po prostu gra jest zabugowana i ma błędy. I w momencie, kiedy zablokuje się, zatnie się na kilka sekund, nawet na 2 sekundy, to wtedy wyłącza się nagrywanie. Tak to działa, śmiesznie. No zobaczmy, co mają nam do zaoferowania panowie.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city. And it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate. If it ever does.
But Marcano dead. New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hank. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go. And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Bob.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
No i mamy do wyboru. Przejmij władzę albo puść miasto. Haha. A tutaj mam opuścić, tak? Naraz, to jest opuść Nowe Bordeaux, a to jest jeźdź do rezydencji plantatora. Co opuszczamy? Mam dylemat. No i tak mnie pewnie zabiją. Spadamy z tym. A może nie? Okej, no wybiorę to, a potem się najwyżej wróci. No i nie spodziewałem się, że będzie taki finał. Będą dwie wersje do wyboru.
After Lincoln vanished, Cassandra took control of the city's underworld. It wasn't a crime boss from Boston to Miami who respected her claim, though, so commission, the Colombians, the Cubans, they all went after her. They realized too late they had no idea who they were fighting. Johnny Galante, throat slit, watching Deep Throat in a porn theater. And Manny Moreno, set on fire outside his daughter's quinceañera. Severo Garcia, buried alive on the beach, drowned when the tide came in. Anton Bagrov, beaten to death with crowbars in the parking lot of the Briar Patch. And then the real criminals came for her. The governor declared martial law, sent in the National Guard. So Cassandra shot him in the head on the steps of the Capitol building. After that, everyone got the message. The city belonged to Cassandra. But the government is like a rogue elephant. It's murderous and patient and never forgets. So the state pulled funding for the schools, city maintenance, you name it. If they couldn't get Cassandra, they'd strangle the city until it gave her up. Hurricane Cassandra, the locals called it. I don't think anyone expected the damage to be so severe, that the levees would completely fail, that the flooding would wipe out half the city and force the other half to leave, that the city would turn into the ghost town it is today. It's hard to believe, really. A major American city being left to rot like that? Some say Cassandra was one of the thousands who drowned in the flood. Others say she slipped away to the swamps and still rules what's left of the city's underworld from the bayou. Either way, she's a ghost. She hasn't been seen in years. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Langan made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
No i to chyba finał. I tak zakończyliśmy naszą przygodę z Mafią 3. Cześć.